servicing a set of our six forks with mixed 30s at the track. Dumped the oil previously. Pull the cartridge out. Should be, yeah. valve setting was too soft, so we're going to change the valves. Got Manny reinstalling all the parts after they were cleaned. Bottoming bumper. Got the seal head. O-ring. Got the internal spacing. Install the clamp shim. Now the valving. Manny, where are you from?
I'm from Brazil.
Brazil. Service the piston. Clean the piston with a toothbrush. Check plate, spring, top hat, spacer. A dab of Loctite didn't hurt. Snug that up. The 13 mil right here. Check plate. Now, get that top out spring clipped on. Piston band. Manny's gonna disassemble the rebound side. That loose. cartridge out, or valve assembly, I mean. Everything up nicely. There's your clamp shim, there's your valving. Piston. Check plate. Trek spring, top hat, sleeve. Pull the rebound holder out. There's Tony and Lewis right there. Everything in order. Boom. Nice and neat. It's your needle. Rebound holder. It's your top out spring with internal spacing. Bottoming bumper, spacing. Very nice, very nice. Spring buffer, and your metering rod. There we go. Now we put everything back together. This is the rebound side. Slap that guy on. Almost pulled the mani. Like second nature to me. Everything was cleaned. There we go. In our opinion, if you don't do a full cartridge service, it's not really a service. Just a dump and fill. If you want it to perform at its best, make sure everything's clean in and out. Piston was clean, surface. Valving changes is necessary on the rebound for now. Got a 10 clamp. Now we put all our little spacers in. Dab of Loctite never hurt. Make sure the check plate is always able to move free so you don't crush it. I see that a lot. Just some band. I'm sure there's a bleed on here, which there is no bleed. So we need to add a bleed now. Adding a bleed to the cartridge. Because it makes it a lot easier to bleed the cartridge. If I were to ship these forks out, oil, because it'd be essentially on its side, oil would come out of the cartridge, the customer would get it and be like, hey, it's not working properly. Sometimes it takes a long time to bleed these cartridges when there's no bleed hole in the top. And we're just doing the number 76 bleed. Delicate drill bit, so you gotta be very careful. So if he lays this bike down, oil comes out of the cartridge, it'll take a couple seconds for it to bleed itself out. Same if I ship this fork, it wouldn't take more than a few pumps to get the air out of the cartridge. Most of the time these old ones come with this bleed, but some of the older stuff did not. Got a bleed hole. It's necessary. Throw this back together. Service the forks and we're good to go. Okay. So now we will service the cap. It's not something that really needs to be done that often, nor is it something that anyone ever really does, but I like to do it every so often. So we're taking the preload spacer out. It's got some threads in it, and all you do is unscrew it. See how dirty it is? It's dirty. So now, take that preload adjuster, lock it into place. Take a little bit of heat. Loosen up that Loctite. Take a 22 socket. Loosen that bad boy up. Spacers. Ouch, hot. Should be four of them. There should be another shim in there as well. That pops out this way. Should be a shim right here. Let's let that cool down. And we'll be right back. So now, we'll pull that clip out. When you pull it out, make sure he's stretched up so it's easy to get back on or it's secure. Now we gotta pull the adjuster out. There's two little detent balls and a spring in there. Make sure you be very careful. Sometimes you gotta push in here and then put your fingernail on the underneath the other side. A little bit of a booger sometimes. Just like that. See that? And little, you wiggle it out. Should have a two little ball bearings. Tent spring, O-ring, oops, of the parts. Spacer here. Boom, boom. There should be one spacer in here. It's still hot. And there you go. So now everything's cleaned. We put it all back together. So we'll start with the adjuster. Take a little bit of grease, shove it in the hole. Put this spring in there. It's a little tricky. There we go. Just like that. Make sure you're decent. Yeah, the detents. Yep. Okay. Close it. So it's best to kind of spread this out a little bit. Get this in there. Use your fingernails. Let it clip in. Boom. And then open it back up. There you go. Take this O-ring. Throw it in there. Take a little bit of grease. Put it on the shim. Put that there. Boom. Slide that in like so. More grease. There we go. Now, take a little bit of grease. Put it on these spring washers. What these do is when you clamp everything down, it keeps pressure on the actual cap and adjuster so that it's not loose, because obviously you don't want it snug tight, then you can't turn it. This allows it to keeps pressure on it and allows it to spin. So, slap the guy in there. Now the lock nut. A little bit. That. Back to there. Snug. Turns, it does. So now, put a little bit of grease on the threads in this hex right here. So, this is the tricky part for anyone starting off with this who's never done this before. You have to line those up. So, what I do is I go until it stops and then crank it a little bit, follow. Crank it, follow until it starts catching. And then flip it over and go full soft. O-ring back on. There you have it. Good to go.